goal of each is to mobilize God's people across denominational lines to share Jesus in good news and good deeds with every single one of the 3.5 million residents of Metro Detroit over a 40-day period starting Easter Sunday. The idea started just with a handful of pastors here in the western suburbs. We just were talking about coming together as a few churches, thinking we were really thinking big, getting outside of our own church and partnering with other churches. But then it grew when a church on the east side said, well, what about us? We'd like to be in. And someone said, don't forget about the city and of Detroit, the actual city. And it sort of snowballed larger than we could have imagined.
I had heard Bob Shyrock, who's the pastor at Oak Point Community Church, speak at a church planners conference. He spoke of a dream that he had, one that was inspired by a friend of his in Africa, just to saturate an entire metropolitan area with the gospel.
We estimate that there are at least 150,000 people in our own community that don't know Jesus yet. And we, as one church of 800 people, can't reach them all. And so the big question that God kept asking me is, how could you not be involved as a church? I believe the mission of Jesus that he gave us in Matthew 28 was to reach out to people in our community and to invite them to join us on the fantastic journey of being followers of Jesus and sharing the good news of life through Christ. Joining that with good deeds has been the marching orders for the church since day one.
Really started a couple of years ago where we formed a vision team in our church to really recast the direction, involve our church a lot more in outreach. We had the mission of seeing everything we do at North Oaks to have an outward, outreaching, Great Commission focus.
We have lots of outreaching ministries that we do, and when I hear that there is going to be a bridge that will be connected between the suburbs and the city, I want to be part of it.
I'm going to be involved with churches in downtown Detroit, we're hopefully going to form a sister relationship with all those churches. We're trying to break down the racial divide. We have what we call a Bless Fest. We're going to be doing that in the downriver area. And it'll be a time when we distribute food. We have a jobs fair. Not only will we have a jobs fair, we'll have a financial services program. And we just have a number of different projects that are going to be taking place during this Bless Fest.
We are heading up Unity in the Community Barbecue, so the whole community that needs medical and dental help can come.
Our own community, we've banded together with six other churches to do a joint Good Friday service, as well as participate in a community event called Relay for Life, which is raising money for the cure of cancer.
We have already begun to partner with another local church. We found that we've had the same passion, really wanting to be involved in the city of Detroit and see God's restoration and redemption for the people there. And so what we've done is we've started a ministry called ABCs in the D, and we go down every Saturday. We've got about 40 children in elementary school, and we have a one-to-one ratio, one tutor and one child, every Saturday. And it's amazing.
What we're doing as local churches is dividing up the areas into 1 and 2 square mile sections. And then each church will map out those sections, and we'll have door hangers, and we'll have teams that will go out and simply saturate our area with prayer.
Our youth group is heading off to New York City for a mission trip. They'll be doing a number of things: Mercy Ministry, Vacation Bible School. They'll do prayer walks and street evangelism.
We're going to be serving food off of food trucks in the city. We're going to be renovating houses for our good deeds. Some of the best ideas, I think, are some of the simplest that came from the grassroots congregational level. One idea, so what if every church in our city had a free car wash on the same Saturday, and no matter where you went, you saw free car wash signs?
And our men and our women of our church have a free car wash, and if you come get a free car wash, we'll give you a free hot dog, a free pop, and free prayer.
One of the difficulties always has been in America that churches tend not to work together. We're oftentimes island. But a movement like this won't allow for that. In fact, it pushes us closer together. We unite, and we find not the differences that we have, but the things that we have in common, especially our love for Christ and our desire to see our community change.
I think that's been the beautiful thing about the EACH movement, is you bring all these denominations and all these leaders together, and it creates a humble mind with humility and action, and it's so powerful. God will be honored and glorified.
And now the effort involves hundreds of churches, city and suburb, all over southeastern Michigan, and is beyond anything we could have possibly imagined. It really comes back to Jesus followers telling their story to their family, their friends, their neighbors, and wherever a door is opened. We believe the time is now for something like EACH. With all that our region's been through in Detroit area these last few years, now is the perfect time to deliver a bold message of good news.